डिजाइनिंग, व्हाट इज एडवांस्ड वेब डिजाइनिंग अबाउट एंड व्हाई वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न दिस. ओके, सो दिस वी विल सी फर्स्ट. या सो व्हाट इज अ वेब डिजाइनिंग, व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ वेब डिजाइनिंग. ओके, सो इन टूडेज एरा वी ऑल आर फॉन्ड ऑफ योर लैपटॉप्स, कंप्यूटर्स, टैब्स एंड ऑल. सो वी ब्राउज द थिंग्स. Each and every time we keep on browsing the things, we search for the things what we are in need of. So we find them in the form of web pages. For example, if you don't understand anything, what you do is you just go and Google it. Yes? So when you go Google it, you get the desired result in the form of a web page. So that is a web page. And sometimes you see in the blue color lines, so you find many subtitles, you click on one thing, you go to some other page. So that is one more web page. So such many kind of web pages daily we see in one or the other way, and we find our desired result. So this is a web page. Okay. With the help of internet, you browse the things, and whatever you browse, whatever you get the result, that is in the form of web page. So now we are going to study how to design a web page. Okay. So these are very basic things they have given you in your 11th and 12th standard. Basic web designing, this is. Again, advanced web designing, you will go and learn in your engineering thing and all. Okay. So what is a web designing? It is a process of creating websites and web pages. Yes, your basic web page, you will learn how to create. Okay, now what is a web page? I told you. So a collection of web pages, many web pages together, they make a website. Okay, so for example, if you go to Facebook. So Facebook is a website which has multiple pages linked with each other. So that is a website. If you go to Google, it is a website. www.google.com is a website which is having a collection of web pages which are interlinked with each other. So a collection of web pages which are interlinked with each other makes a website. Okay. And homepage, Google homepage, you might be knowing. The first page of your website is a homepage. Okay. So these are very basic things we have learned in 11th standard also. What is a homepage? What is a web page? Websites, client, server. Yes. So moving on to the further things. Next, HTML5. Now we are going to learn HTML5. Okay, due to COVID-19 situation, your board has told that no need to use Ubuntu and all. You can just take a simple text editor, that is Notepad, and you can execute your programs in Internet Explorer or your Google Chrome, they have told. So I'll be using Notepad as a text editor to type the things, and your Google Chrome I'll be using, sometimes Internet Explorer I'll be using. Okay, so no need to use Ubuntu this time. So it supports mobile technology. Why we are using HTML5? Simple HTML also we have. HTML5 also we have. Okay. So why HTML5? Because it supports mobile technology. Okay. Nowadays, mobile is the very common thing in each and everyone's hand. Our mobile is there only. Okay. And with the internet, very good smartphones we have. So mobile technology it supports. So it is very good to learn HTML5 instead of HTML. This is the main thing and very basic thing. And major browsers which we are going to which supports HTML5 are Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Microsoft Edge, Safari, Opera, Apple. These are some of the major browsers which supports HTML5. So this is very simple thing. We'll move further now. Yes. The most important thing what we have to learn and what you have to understand, for exam point of view also, forms are very important. In 11th also you have learned what are forms, but still we will revise a bit. Forms in HTML are used to accept user input form is a collection of different elements called as controls. Yes, students, what is a form now? Manually also, you might be knowing what is a form. We fill a before, after your 10th standard, before going to 11th standard, you just fill a form, college form. You have a name in front of that box. You'll be having, you fill your name, your address, your phone number, then Aadhaar card number, etc., etc. And which stream you want to go, science, commerce, or arts. And in that stream, which all subjects you want to study, all these basic things, we just fill in the form and we submit it to the college. But now it is an online world. So each and everything is online. Okay, before also we used to fill online forms, but now it has become more common. So you might have seen also, I think you might have seen online form, how it looks, how it has been filled. So a normal form is having name in front of a data text box wherein you fill your name, first name, middle name, last name, your address, your phone number, then your Aadhaar card number. Just now you filled your 12th standard board exam form also. How it was manually a paper, on a paper you filled that form, same type you will get it online. You have to just use your keyboard to fill the form. That is the only difference. Here with hand and pen you fill the form, here with a keyboard you fill the form and send it in few seconds. Okay, so form is very important. Now what is a form, we understood. What are the elements or controls in the form? So students, we have text box, we have radio button, check boxes, submit button, reset button. These are all the controls or elements of a form. Okay. I think you might be remembering, I just don't know, in 11th standard, we have learned all these things. Your text box, what is it, radio button, what is it, all the things we have learned, but still a little bit of brush up will do. Yes, is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so this is a very simple form which I have made for you so that your 11th standard things get clear and it reminds you something what you had learned in 11th long ago, and it will also help you to connect with the 12th standard things after this we are going to learn. Those things also it will help you to connect. Okay. Now, this is a text box. Wherein such type of text boxes are helpful for us to write our first name, middle name, last name, etc., etc. And this is a stream like science or commerce. Here I have taken different element or control. What is this? This is called as a radio button. Circle you can see here. So this is a radio button for science and commerce I have used. Why radio button? Because radio button helps us to make only single selection. Now you tell me, one student can sit or can attend or can be a student of science stream, commerce stream, art stream, yes or no? I think only one student can be only our science students, I can say. You can't tell me that I also study science, commerce, arts also stream. This can't happen. Only one stream we belong. Yes. So when it is so, that time we have to use radio buttons. Okay. When only and only one selection can be made. So that time radio button can be used. Okay. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Mayuri, can you unmute yourself? Raut Mayuri. Yes, I'm waiting, dear. Fast. She's not available. Yes, Pise Khushi.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So what I told you, there is a difference between a checkbox and a radio button. Can you tell me the difference?
Radio button helps us to only make one selection at a time.
Okay.
And checkbox.
Yeah. No doubt your answer was right. But after that, checkbox helps us to
make multiple selections.
Okay. Multiple selections. Here, can you explain me this? For checkboxes, I have taken, see, physics, chemistry, maths. Three things I have taken. Why I have taken checkboxes for them?
Because if we select science stream, then we have to select all the subjects at a time.
Okay, okay, fine. Good, good, good. Yes. So, yeah, you can unmute yourself.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, mute yourself. Yeah, okay. See, students, if you're science students, then it is, you can't say that I want only physics, ma'am. I'll only study physics. Don't want other subjects. No, you can't tell that. You have to, it's compulsory to take such subjects, right? So what we do is, that time when we have a choice of selecting more than one options, we go for checkboxes. Okay, so that I can select physics, chemistry, maths. Now you people are IT students, so English, IT, bio and all. So six subjects you will choose among all other subjects. We have Hindi, Marathi, CS, electronics, but those subjects you have not chosen. So you are in IT classroom. Yes. Or IT students you are, because you have skipped those subjects, and six subjects, whichever you wanted, you selected. So this is what is checkbox. And see here, students, this is a bigger box. You can see this is for address. Okay. Now, students, see, this text box also is a text box. This is also a text box. But here, this is a single line text box and this is a multi-line text box. Why we need multi-line text box for address? To write more than one line. Our address can't get over in one line or one word. We need 2 to 3 lines sometimes. So for that, we needed to take a bigger text box, and a bigger text box will be given to us by a text area. This element or control, that I'll make you understand how it is. And see here, this is select. Select a tag gives us this drop down. Can you see this drop down list? So this is because of select a tag, which gives us drop down list. Okay. Regarding this, a program also I'll make you understand in Notepad. This is a submit button. Means see here, for example, if I've given here ABC, if I've taken science stream, if I've taken subjects physics, chemistry, and if I've written the address here as ABC, yes, Kalyan. See, I've written ABC, Katemanevli, Kalyan East. This is my address. And if I say Nagpur, Nagpur will be selected as my city. When I say submit, see this, submit, everything is gone. Where it is gone? It is gone to the server for further processing. Okay. Now, students, this is what is submit button. It sends your data to the server for further processing. Now, what is this clear button? Clear button is nothing but whatever you have written, the whole. Now, this was a very simple form. We have form of one page, the whole page. If you find, no, I should not write now, I have to delete everything. Later on, I'll fill the form. If you feel so, what you will do is you will clear the form. When you click on this, the whole form will be cleared. Okay. So this was the basic form. We will go with the program, means things will be clear with you. Okay. Just, yes. So students, I'll keep it here. Okay. Now this output, I'll keep it here, and simultaneously I'll be teaching you these things so that it will be clear. Now HTML tag, HTML close tag is below. Head tag close. Title tag close. And I have given the title of the program as basic tags. These are the basic tags of HTML. I think you remember this. Okay, no need for more explanation in this. Now, form tag. What is a form tag? I am going to make a form. This is my form. Yes. So for that, form open tag and form close tag is below. Okay. In the form open tag, name I have to give. It is a good practice to name the things. So I have named my form as F1. You can give any name to your form, F1, F2, F3, or else any name. Okay, ABC also you can give. So for form, it is F1 I have given. Now students, H1 open tag, H1 close tag. Inside that, what I have written? Students data. Yes, I'll highlight this if you want. Yes, do you see here? H1 align is equal to center I have given, so that students data, what I've written inside H1 open and H1 close tag will come in the center. See here, it has come in the center. And because of H1 tag, it is font biggest and boldest. Okay. If I give H2, it will be lesser bigger and lesser bolder. Okay. This was very simple. Now name. Name is simply written here. Here also the name will be simply written. Okay. This is the very good thing of HTML, that simply also we can write few things. Now, input type is equal to text. Input type is equal to text. Name is equal to N1. BR tag. Okay. So, yes. Input type is equal to text. This input type is equal to text. See here, this is input is the tag. Type is the attribute of input tag, and this type attribute has value text. Okay. So input tag has many, many attributes. One of the attribute is type attribute, and this type attribute has value text. Okay. Now second attribute of input tag is name. See here, name is the attribute of input tag, which has the value N1. Okay. Now, when you say input type is equal to text, it will give you a single line text box. This is my text box, single line text box. And the name of this text box is N1. Why I'm naming the text boxes? Because when I call the things, when I use the functions, it will help me. Okay, now, just now I called Khushi, I called, and Mayuri, I called. You have names now. So I could call you, or else if you are in the college, you have your particular roll numbers with the help of which I can call you easily. Otherwise, what I should tell, I can't figure you out. Now this is online. It is very difficult to figure you out. Otherwise I have to, in the college, I have to tell, hey, you stand up and all. Yes. So that is quite difficult. So here, as I can call you with your name and roll number, in the same way, I can also call the values of the text. Here I can fill a value in this text box. I can get it. I can fetch it when I give the name to these elements. Okay. So the input type is equal to text will give you this text box. And the name of this text box I have kept as N1. Okay. Now, BR tag. BR tag is just like enter. When you want to say enter, you have to use BR tag in the coding. It is break rule. Okay. So when I gave BR tag, it came, my cursor came to the next line. Now stream has come on the next line because of BR tag. Now next, stream is simply written here. One sec. Yes. Am I audible? Anyone till here? Any doubts? If you have, you can ask.
Yes, ma'am.
No doubts?
No.
Shall I continue?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So now, See, students, here, stream. Stream is written here and stream is written here. It is simply written, okay? You can write anything like that, simply, okay? Now, input type is equal to radio. Input type is equal to radio. As I told you, this is the attribute of input tag. Now, this one attribute can have many values. Now, see here, here type attribute had value what? Text. When I gave text as a value, it gave me text box. But here, again, same attribute I'm using. Input is the tag. Again, type only attribute I'm using. Type is the attribute. So, but same attribute I'm using, but the value is different here. Instead of text, I have written radio to get what? To get radio button. So this you have to concentrate. What you will write, that you will get. If you write text, you will get a text box. If you write a radio, you will get a radio button. So input type is equal to radio gave me this first radio button, circle wala. Okay. Name is equal to R1. Name of this radio button is R1. This button's name is R1. Value is equal to signs. So see students, if value is equal to signs, if you don't write also, it's okay. Why? Because this value will go to the server while processing it goes. Okay. If you don't write it also, it's okay. But it is a good practice to write. So I wrote. Otherwise, if you don't write and execute this particular program also, it will work. Fine. Now this signs. This signs, what I have written here outside the tag is nothing but this signs. If I cancel this signs, means the signs from here will be canceled. Okay. So this signs is nothing but outside the tag, what I've written is nothing but this signs. Okay. Now students, one more thing in 11th standard, you had studied that input tag is a empty tag. Okay, it doesn't have a close tag. Now, for example, HTML open tag, we have HTML close tag, title open, title close tag, body open, body close tag, but input tag, no need to close that tag. Okay, so this whole thing is see here, from here till here, this input tag, open tag it is, no close tag for that. And outside this, I've written signs, which is this signs. Okay, now. Input type is equal to radio gave me this second radio button. Name is equal to R1. R1 is the name of this button. Value is a commerce. I told you this. And this commerce is nothing but this commerce. And then BR tag. BR tag, I'll come down. Whatever will be there will be typed down on my output screen. Now, students, simply I have written here subjects. I wanted it. So here it has been simply typed as subjects. Input type is equal to checkbox. Now we'll come to checkbox.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, aapne wahan science ke idhar BR wala tag kyun nahi lagaya?
Haan, mujhe na. वो साइंस और कॉमर्स को एक ही लाइन में लाना था, इसीलिए मैंने बीआर नहीं लगाया. ओके, देखो आउटपुट में आपको दिख रहा है साइंस और कॉमर्स एक ही लाइन में है. हाँ, अगर आप बीआर लगाओगे तो वो कॉमर्स नीचे आ जाएगा. क्लियर? ओके, मींस आई वांटेड माय फॉर्म टू डिजाइन लाइक दिस. इफ यू वॉन्ट योर फॉर्म टू डिजाइन इन सम अदर वे, यू कैन डू. ओके, no need that to how I have made like that, only you should made. Okay, fine. So one more thing, students, take a screenshot of this if you can, because such type of programs are asked in the exam. Simple programs also are asked for 5 marks. So that time you should not feel that this is very simple. I know this, how come it is for 5 marks? Sometimes students do such mistakes. Arre, ye to bahut easy hai, ye to 5 marks ke liye nahi aayega, kuch to gadbad hai, ye chhod dete hain. प्रोग्राम ऐसे भी होता है, तो ऐसा नहीं है. सिंपल प्रोग्राम्स भी 5 मार्क्स के लिए पूछे जाते हैं, और दूसरा 5 मार्क्स का क्वेश्चन बहुत डिफिकल्ट होता है. ओके, सो जस्ट टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट एंड ट्राई एट होम, इट विल वर्क और नो, यू हैव टू सी एंड प्रैक्टिस. नाउ नेक्स्ट विल गो टू चेक बॉक्स. वन थिंग आई डिडंट टेल यू स्टूडेंट, सी हियर, नेम इज इक्वल टू आर वन एंड नेम इज इक्वल टू आर वन. सेम आर वन आई हैव गिवन फॉर बोथ द रेडियो बटन्स. why because see in radio button only one selection is there, no more than one selection is allowed. When it is so, means that time the radio buttons should be named the same. Okay, now here students, name of the check boxes are different. C1 C2 C3, I have three check boxes here and all the three check boxes are named C1 C2 C3. So here we have multiple selection, more than one selection, and all the selections are different. No doubt I am selecting more than one, but physics is totally different subject, chemistry is different subject, and maths is different subject. Tino alag alag hai, they are not the same. So that time, no doubt I'm selecting more than one subject, but all the selections are different. They don't relate to each other. So for this, we are giving C1, C2, C3, that is different names for all the checkboxes. Okay, I think this is clear. Input type is equal to checkbox, gave me this first checkbox. Name is equal to C1, is checkbox ka naam hai C1, this checkbox name is C1. Value is equal to physics, I told you this, why it is so. And this physics is nothing but this physics, okay. Now next, second and third line, I think the same it is. I no need to again explain. Input type is equal to checkbox. Name of the checkbox is C2, and outside the tag, what chemistry I have given, that is this chemistry. Okay, I think this still here, it is clear. Now next is address. Yes, so address is simply written here. Here also address is simply written. Okay, the text box length was bigger so that address has come down. Otherwise, it was okay. It is okay. And text area tag. Now students, see here, one thing is, this is, you have to note this, text area open tag till here it is, and this is text area close tag. Now this text area writing syntax is quite different. These are all written in, what is this, why we are writing so, because it's a syntax. Isko bolte hai syntax. Input type is equal to radio in double quotes. What is it? It is the syntax, the way of writing. See, we have way of writing English subject with full stops, exclamatory marks, commas, yes, double quotes, colon, and all that in English. Lekin Hindi mein aise nahi hota. Hindi mein purna viram aata hai. The way of writing, the style of writing is different, because what is it? The way of writing, the syntax of writing English and Hindi and various different languages. Here also the syntax, we say syntax of writing HTML is this. So students, for text area, means the text area is the tag which gives you a bigger text box. The way of writing text area is text area open tag, text area close tag will give you a bigger text box, only so much. But if you want the text box according to your wish, means you have to add few attributes of text area. This is a tag. Text area is a tag. Rows is the attribute of text area, which has the value 5. Calls is the attribute of text area, which has the value 50. Okay. Now I wanted my text area, that is that bigger box, in this size only. So I have given rows is equal to 5 and calls is equal to 50. Why rows 5 means how much? See here. One row, two row, three row, four row, five row, means rows means this, see here, like this, horizontal. Okay, horizontal is the rows. So five rows will take how much height? Na, that much height your box will be. Okay, and calls is 50. 50 means, see here, calls means vertical lines, vertical lines. Columns means vertical lines. So 50 columns will take how much space? That much bigger your text box will be. Okay, clear? Akanksha, you can unmute and tell me, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So rows means it will increase the height of your text box. That is address wala text box, bigger text box. And calls will increase the width of your text box. Okay, Now, text area close. So all these attributes and their values where we have to mention in the open tag, we have to mention. Okay. Hope this is clear now. Now, students, we'll go to the further part. Yes. Yes, see here. Now, city, I have written city here. City is here. Okay. Now, students, city. We have single selection or multiple selection sometimes here. That is, you might have done this while filling the 11th standard form online, something you will do. Na? So which all colleges you like the most, you will give the preference first, this, second, this. Like that, it can be colleges here, the cars, colors, like this, for this. These things we use a drop-down list. So here, this drop-down list is for city. Now, select tag open and select tag close only gives you this much drop-down list. But see here, in this drop-down list, I have options. First option is Pune, second Nagpur, third is Solapur. Yes. So when I want these three options, means what I have to do? First, I have to take a select tag close. Inside that, option tag open and option tag close. Inside that, whichever option you want to mention, that option you have to write. Option tag open, option tag close. Second option, whichever you want to take, that you will write second. Third, like this. Okay. So 10, 15, 20, how many options you want to give, that many options you can give by giving, writing it inside option tag open and option tag close. Okay. Here, this is the same thing. Name is equal to CT. The name of this drop-down list is CT. CT means, for city shortcut, I have written as CT. For form, I'll write F1. For textbox, I'll write T1. Second textbox, if I take, I'll write T2. Okay. R1 for radio button. Checkbox C1, I'll write. Means whatever names you're giving, it should suit your elements or controls. Like that, you have to name. Okay. I think this is clear. Okay. And in 11th also, you had done. So I think this has been brushed up very nicely. Yes. Now next, input type is equal to submit. This will give you this submit button. This submit button, it will give. Value is equal to submit. Now first, let me tell what is a submit button. Input type is equal to submit. See here again, this is the value of attribute type. For type, what all we have used? Text, radio, checkbox. Yes. Now submit we are using. So whatever value you will give, that like that element you are giving, getting in the form. So input type is equal to submit, gave you this submit button, and this button is clickable. Clickable button you will get. Now on top of that, submit is written. Instead of this, if I want click or click here, you might have seen many things on the internet nowadays. It will be written click. Click here, click all, whatever it is. So it's looking at that. When I see click here, I'll obviously go and click there. Means it will, it is user friendly. It is helping me to understand the thing. Yes. When it will say clear, means I am understanding that, okay, this button is clearing the things. So this is basic thing. So when you are using submit button, means on top of it, submit should be written. So when you want so, you have to write value is equal to submit. When you write value is equal to submit, on top of this button, submit will be written. If you want on top of this submit button, clear. Sorry. If you want on top of this submit button, click. You have to write value is equal to click. On top of this, if you want click here, you have to write value is equal to click here. Means input type is equal to submit. Value is equal to whatever you write, that will be on top of this button. Okay. Now, and this button, what it does, it takes your form data and it will go to the server for further processing. It sends your form data, whatever you have filled in the form. When you say submit, that form's data will go to the server for further processing. when you are filling the 12th standard board exam form and you say submit, means your form has been gone to the Maharashtra State Board, and then you will get the hall ticket. It is so. Okay. Now, input type is equal to reset. Reset button will give you a button which is clickable. Now again, value is equal to clear. I have written here, clear will come. This is also the same. One more thing I didn't tell you, students. Suppose someone has forgotten to write value is equal to submit. He didn't give the value. Means here, by default, it will come submit query. Submit query, it will come. Why? Because we want to show the user, the one who is dealing with the form, we have to show compulsory that baki sabko chodo, but we want to compulsory show that this is a submit button. You have to write your form and go and click here only. So when I want to tell, so for that submit value is equal to submit, if you don't give, by default it will show as submit query. Okay. So I think this is clear. Form close, body close, HTML head close, HTML close. Head by mistake I have closed here. I should not do so. Yes. So this is it. Okay. Anyone, any doubts in this? This was a program from your 11th standard wherein we had few of the controls. They have only mentioned in your textbook. And I took the program because if these things are clear with you, then only you will understand the further part. Okay. Anyone can, Nanma, can you unmute? Yes, dear. Where is she? No, students are not there.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Did you understand any doubts here?
No, ma'am.
No doubts.
She left the meeting, ma'am.
Left the meeting?
Yes.
Okay. Fine. I'll ask someone else. Yes, Abigail.
Yes, miss.
Yes. Did you understand everything? Any doubts?
No, miss.
Okay, no doubts. And did you understand why we take for radio button, why we take the same name and for checkboxes different names? Did you understand?
Yes, miss.
Any doubts there?
No, miss.
No doubts. Okay, fine. Yes. Yes.
Shall I mute?
Aryan, yeah. Yeah, mute yourself. Aryan. Yes, Aryan. Where is Isha? She's there, no? Isha, the one girl who asks me many things. Can you tell me what I ask? Please unmute yourself. No, the students here are not unmuting themselves. Oh God. Yes, okay. We will move on further. Later on, I'll be asking you things. Yes. See here, students. Now we are going to learn. Yes. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So now we are going to study the new input types from your textbook, what they have given. First one is input type is equal to color, defines a color picker. Okay. So students, see here, each and every input type does different things, and each and everything we are going to learn. I've made a single program wherein each and every input type, how they are working, I'll show. So what is it? Input type is equal to color. How to write it? I'll show. One sec.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
मैम ये रेडियो बटन और इसमें अलग अलग नाम के लेते हो वापस बताओ ना
ओके हु इज दिस आकांक्षा
यस मैम
okay. Radio button, see here, dear. In radio button, there is compulsory one selection.
Yes. Yeah?
Leave other things. Only one selection is there. One sec. Just give me. Yes, radio button, it is only one selection we have to do, okay? But checkboxes have different selection, so different name. Whatever it is, if you have 100 radio buttons only also, even then we have to select only one thing. So for this, only for one selection, like they have the value same, they are named the same, because we are not bothering about the other things, because whatever it is, if 100 radio buttons, 50 radio buttons, still we have to select only one thing. So one name we are giving. But checkboxes, see here, checkboxes, if you're a science student, you will take physics, you will take on chemistry, you will take on maths, but all these subjects are different, no? No doubt we are selecting more than one subject. But all these subjects don't relate to each other only. Maths is totally different. Physics is totally different. So, so for that, we give different names. For checkboxes and for radio buttons, single name we give for single selection. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah. So, students, see here. First is input type is equal to color we are learning. Yeah.
उसमें आपने बताया था कि रेडियो बटन यूज करेंगे तो दो में से एक ऑप्शन सिलेक्ट कर सकते
हैं। हाँ, सिंगल सिलेक्शन।
लेकिन उसमें आपने R1 नहीं, उसमें लेकिन आपने R1 यूज किया था और चेक बॉक्स में C1 C2 C3 था। अगर C1 C1 लिखेंगे तो उसमें भी दो ऑप्शन होगा ना?
नहीं, R1 लिखेंगे तो सिंगल सिलेक्शन है ना, तो सिंगल सिलेक्शन मतलब जितने भी रेडियो बटन हो एक ही सिलेक्शन है तो करना है।
नहीं, जैसे कि R1 बोला था तो मैं से एक ही सिलेक्ट होगा ना?
हाँ, एक ही सिलेक्ट होगा।
तो
बराबर है, तुम एक क्वेश्चन बोल रहे हो, तुम ही आंसर भी दे रहे हो।
नहीं तो वैसा रेडियो बटन जैसा काम करता है वैसा चेकबॉक्स भी कर सकता है।
अगर आप चेकबॉक्स को सेम नेम दोगे ना तो वो मल्टीपल सिलेक्शन नहीं करेगा। वो मल्टीपल सिलेक्शन इसलिए करता है क्योंकि आप नाम भी अलग दे रहे हो और उसका काम है मल्टीपल सिलेक्शन करना, समझा? अभी इस रेडियो बटन और चेकबॉक्स सेम ही काम करेगा तो दो अलग अलग चीजों की जरूरत ही क्या है, समझा? रेडियो बटन का काम अलग है, चेकबॉक्स का काम अलग है। रेडियो बटन इज फॉर सिंगल सिलेक्शन, चेकबॉक्स इज फॉर मल्टीपल सिलेक्शंस, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस रेडियो बटन इज नेम्ड द सेम एंड चेकबॉक्स इज नेम्ड द डिफरेंट।
अगर मैं C1 C2 C3 लिखा कोडिंग,
आप एक काम करो, आपको अभी कोडिंग मिल गया ना, आप घर में प्रैक्टिस करो एक बार और चेंजेस करके देखो, आपको खुद को समझ में आ जाएगा, समझा? ओके, shall I move further?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay, fine. Yes, students, this was the R1, C1, this all we have learnt in 11th standard. If you find more difficulty, you can open up your 11th standard book and study a little bit. This, I went through that because further part you must would have not understood. Still I have not started only the actual your textbook, because those things you are not knowing. Okay, so go through the 11th standard textbook once, through HTML you go through. Okay, and in the textbook I think same thing it is given. Please don't go through it, like make the changes in 11th standard textbook. Somewhere they have given C1 ke liye C1 C1 C1, they have given, make it C1 C2 C3 C4, like that you make. Okay, and this is very important for your multiple choice question. So radio button sing the same name and checkbox is different name, so you have to keep in mind. So next, moving on to the further things, input type is equal to color defines the color picker. So what is the color picker? I'll show you the output first and then I'll show you how it is used. One sec. See, students, can you see this is called as color picker? Okay, when you want to show, you have to say input type is equal to color. Till now, we read input type is equal to radio, text, checkbox, submit, reset, and all that. Now we are learning input type is equal to color, which will give you a color palette or color picker. From this, you can pick any color. See your red color, light red, dark red, and anything. If you go to light red, dark red, dark blue, anything you can choose. Yellow, you can select and you can choose whatever it is. This is in RGB format, which refers to the primary colors of light red and green. Sorry, red, green, and blue that are used in monitors, television screens, digital cameras, and scanners, and all that. Okay. You might have studied this in physics, RGB format. So when you want to show in your program, see students, this is not a program. What I did is to make you understand the different input types, I have taken everything in a single program. Okay. So first one is input type is equal to color. So this is it. It gives you a color palette, which is in RGB format. Okay. Now, the coding for this, I'll show how to use this. See students, here I have made the program HTML open tag, close tag, head open tag, head close tag, title open tag, title close tag. These are the basic tags which you already know. Body open tag, body close tag is below. In the body section, I have given you yes, in the body section, I have written form. This is also a form which I'm going to make. So form name is equal to F1. I have given H1 open tag, H1 close tag. Inside that, I have written a form. Okay. That heading I have given. Any heading you can give. Align is equal to center I have given so that whatever form has been written comes in the center. Okay. Yes. So here this is the output and this is the coding. So H1 close form. So form is in the center because of H1 tag. It is highest and boldest. Now color is simply written here. Color also is simply written here. Input type is equal to color gave you this text box, which is in the form of color palette. When you click this, it gives you a color palette so that any color you can choose. And name is equal to C1 means the name of this color palette is C1. BR tag 2 times I have given so that more space I wanted. I wanted to say 2 times enter. When I want to say normally 2 times enter, what I'll do is 2 times enter key I will press on the keyboard so that it will enter 2 times. Yes. Yes, so input type is equal to color. Input type is equal to color. Name is equal to C1 is the name of the color palette. 2 times BR means 2 times enter. Okay, now next is number. Yes, this one. Number is simply written. This is also simply written on the output page. Okay. Input type is equal to number will give you a text box which will only have numbers. If you type something else, it will not take. And the name of that text box is N1. Okay. Now I'll show you that. Yes, see your number is written here, the second one. Input type is equal to number gives you this text box, which will take input from the users, only numbers, not any other things. Okay, name is equal to N1, the name of this text box is N1. Okay, two times br, so two times enter here. See here students, now I'll show you. See, these are numbers. These are down arrow and up arrow. See here, it will go in minus also. And it will go in plus also. See, okay, I can increase and decrease the numbers. And if I type some digit alphabet, see here, I'm typing alphabets actually. A, B, C, I have typed on my keyboard, but it is not typing that on this text box. Why? Because input type is equal to number, takes only numbers, not other things. Anything, whatever you type, it will not take. Now students, what is the use of such type of text boxes? If you have gone through any online form, there one option will be there, age. In front of that one text box will be there. Normally a small text box we get in front of age. In that text box we have to, one sec, so students, you have age in front of that small text box you get, wherein you can write your age. But normally in online forms, you write your age. Suppose if it is 17 years old, if you are, you don't write SEVENTEEN, right? You write 1 and 7, right? You write 1 and 7. So you write only numbers, and only numbers are allowed in that text box. When you want to do so, you have to take input type is equal to numbers. Okay. Got it? Akanksha, you can unmute and tell me, dear, if you are you understanding?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm audible clearly, na?
Uh-huh.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Yes. So when you want such type of text boxes wherein age in front of that one small text box you want to give, wherein only numbers can be given, that time such type of text boxes we can give, wherein we can write input type is equal to number. Okay. I think it's almost 7:23. So I'll, I think only one URL this I can explain. After that, we'll stop. Okay. Now next students, next is this URL. So input type is equal to URL. It defines a field for entering a URL. Okay. It defines a field for entering a URL. When you want to give a text box wherein only URL can be given, that time such type of input type is equal to URL you have to give. One sec. Yes. See your students here. What is a URL? See students, abc@gmail.com is not a URL. It is a mail ID. What is a URL? http://abc@gmail.com. This is a URL. What is a URL? On the top of your Google screen, one address bar you will write. That address bar, www.google.com/gmail.com, whatever you write and say enter, you will get that. So that is the address. That is the URL. Yes. For example, I have written this. Okay. So what is a URL? http://, and further things. This is the URL. Okay. Now students, yes, this is a URL. One sec. See students, two things have given. Number, if I give, it won't take. Only this you will take. It will take. When I say submit, it will go to the server for further processing. If I write URL wrong, that is this, if I write, I should get an error message. Okay. because this is not the URL. See, can you see? Please enter a URL it is giving me, because this is the not you see. Please enter a URL here. You can see. Please enter a URL, because URL, how it is written? http://. This is the way to write the URL. I have not written so. So when I write wrong things, it will give me a error message. When I say submit, it will give me the error message as please enter a URL. This you might have seen in online forms. When you write wrong things, okay, instead of age, if you write SEVEN, it will take, if it takes in the beginning while submitting the form, it will give you the error. And now here also one URL it asked me, okay, it has taken also, but when I say submit, it will say me write a correct format, please enter a URL. This is not a URL. Okay, so here in new input elements, what all we have learned, how to take a color palette. So what you will write for this, input type is equal to color. Input type is equal to number will give you a text box wherein we can write any number and we can increase and decrease the value of that number. Okay, but other than numbers, it will not take any other things. Okay, so this is used for age and all in the online form. And when you want to give a URL, okay, and not any other things, you have to say input type is equal to URL. It will take a proper format of a URL, not other than this, nothing it will take. If you give wrong URL, it will not say submit. Your form will be stuck there only till you give the proper format. It will not go to the server for further processing. Okay, till here anyone is having any doubt, because further parts I can't teach you today. Anyone? Yes, everyone has understood.